we are going to download ADSB decoder from xdeco.org. I have provided the link in the description of the video. On this page, you need to download this zip file regardless of if you have 32-bit or 64-bit Windows operating system. This link opens up Google Drive folder. When the folder is open, you need to click download icon. Zip file will be downloaded to your downloads folder. Now extract it using your favorite unzip program. Change its name to something you like. Move it to C drive or some other folder within C drive. It is best not to save it in the program files folder. This is because Windows have restrictions on program files folder. Now open up CMD terminal. We also call it CMD window. You can also use PowerShell if you like. Now change the location to the folder where you have stored modsdeco2. On the command prompt, you need to paste the command that I have provided in the description of the video. There are two versions of the command. One is with the minimum parameters and the other one have some additional parameter. After writing or pasting the command, press enter and it will try to find the device. In my case, device is RTL dongle and it will show some basic information about the dongle and the setup. Now you are ready to receive ADSB signals from passing aircrafts. Please remember that you need to keep this window open. You can minimize the window, but do not close it. To access the web interface, go to localhost :8088. This is the port number you have set up in the command line. Modsdeco2 decoder has built-in web server. We have specified the port of the web server in the command line. Now open up your browser and type localhost :8088 to open the web interface. On the web interface, I am going to second tab, which is flights. Here we can see all the flights currently in range. Leftmost arrows show the level of the flight. The first flight is maintaining its altitude while the second flight is about to land. On the rightmost side, you see a globe icon. Click on it and it will open up the map interface. In the map interface, we see a lot of information about the flight, as well as we can see the physical location of the aircraft. It is the current location of the aircraft and it is updated as the aircraft flies to its destination. It provides a lot of information like its country, its temperature, and a lot more. In the CMD window or PowerShell window, we see all the messages coming from the aircraft. These messages contain different type of information. Messages in this window are processed by the software and shown in a more human-friendly manner on the web interface. First tab of web interface shows these charts. Contacts distance chart shows the number of contacts we have received and the distance. This chart shows we have received how many contacts from the distance given in the chart. We usually receive more contacts from a smaller distance as compared to the longer distance. The aircraft flying far away from us. The second chart showing messages per hour. Blue line shows the total number of messages, while the red line shows the position messages. Position messages are messages which tells the longitude and latitude of the aircraft. Coverage pattern, which is on the lower left of the screen. This chart is very interesting. It tells you the direction and the distance of the aircrafts that you have received so far. Fourth chart, which is on the bottom right, is messages. It tells you the total number of messages you are receiving right now. In the web interface, fourth tab contains three submenus. One of these submenus is log. This log shows all the messages being received by the system. Stats is a submenu under the miscellaneous tab. It shows all type of statistics collected by the system. It tells the total messages received and the breakdown of these messages. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please consider subscribing.